Guns are the essence of military power. Artillery is the god of war. So said Joseph Stalin. Yes, even in modern warfare, victory is measured by firepower. It is the big gun that has made all the difference between rousing victory and humiliating defeat. It is not surprising, therefore, that the bulwark of any country's defense forces is by necessity its regiment of artillery. The motto of the artillery is Sarvatra Izzat O Iqbal, everywhere with honor and glory. True to their motto, Indian gunners today continue to perform their duties with pride and dedication.
मराठों का प्रिय लेजियम अब पूरे देश में लोकप्रिय है। छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज की सेना में बहुत ही चाव से किया जाने वाला व्यायाम आज देश के कोने कोने लहरों का गीत, समुद्र में लहरों के उतार चढ़ाव के साथ जाल फेंकते हुए मछुआरों का मनोहारी नृत्य,
मेरी सिग्नल को मेरी सिग्नल को मेरी सिग्नल को।
संथाल वृत्ति। दक्षिण बिहार के दक्षिण बिहार के संथाल वर्णा में अंकुरित और पल्लवित अब भारत के विभिन्न अंचलों में प्रिय संथाल आदिवासी।
देश के हर भाग में मनाए जाते हैं अपने अपने रीति रिवाज के अनुसार देश की विविधता को एकता के सूत्र में पिरोते हुए।
The SATA branch is slated to play an even more vital role in the future in surveillance for the army. The branch comprises a number of radars for detection of enemy guns and mortars and for battlefield surveillance. To enable accurate firing by guns, the SATA branch also provides real-time metrological data through sophisticated mobile computer-based systems. They are also responsible for accurate survey of gun areas and targets. The air defense branch of the artillery is equipped with modern guns and missiles. These dedicated gunners lay out a deadly reception for any marauding enemy aircraft and provide the much-needed air defense cover for ground forces, airfields, and vital installations. Their deadly surface-to-air missiles have a very high success rate in destroying targeted aircraft. Any enemy aircraft which dares to violate our airspace has to face the wrath of the air defense gunners, and very few aircraft escape or their pilots survive to describe the ordeal. Let us participate in a coordinated engagement of enemy aircraft by all components of the air defense branch. Cannons are the locks and keys of an empire. Very good. Any enemy aircraft which dares to violate our airspace has to face the wrath of the air defense gunners, and very few aircraft escape or their pilots survive to describe the ordeal. Let us participate in a coordinated engagement of enemy aircraft by some components of the air defense branch. Cannons are the locks and keys of an empire, said Emperor Akbar. The long history of the regiment of artillery is a saga of courage, sacrifice, and devotion to duty. The oldest gun can be found at Fort William in Calcutta. Guns were first used in India by Babur and the Mughals, the Sikhs, and the Marathas. The first Indian artillery unit was formed on 28 September 1827 as the 5 Bombay Mountain Battery. But the true Indianization of the artillery was permitted by the British only from 5th January 1935 with the raising of the A-Field Brigade. For the first time, young Indian officers were posted to this regiment. They were 2nd Lieutenants P.S. Gyani and P.P. Kumaramangala. The gunners distinguished themselves during the Second World War at Bir Hakim in North Africa and Kaladan Valley in Burma. Then at Chushul in 1962, Longewala and Amritsar, you had one photograph for it, or two, one, repeat. The gunners distinguished themselves during the Second World War at Bir Hakim in North Africa and Kaladan Valley in Burma. Then at Chushul in 1962. Longewala and Amritsar in 1965, and in Bangladesh in 1971. The gunners of the Indian Army are truly proud of their regiment, which has given the nation 3 chiefs of army staff, Generals Kumaramangalam, Malhotra, and now General Rodriguez. Gunners are proud of their traditions and look up to their predecessors and heroes for inspiration. Their officers and men form a team that is solid and one built on the principles of professionalism, camaraderie, and brotherhood. For the Indian gunners, their guns are their colors, which they veritably worship. The gunners take their oath on the gun and defend them to the last. Repeat. For the Indian gunners, their guns are their colors, which they veritably worship. They take their oath on their guns and defend them to the last. Havaldar Umrao Singh is a shining example of this tradition. He fought off an attack on his gun with a wooden rod after all ammunition was expended. For this gallant act, he was awarded the Victoria Cross. He remembers the momentous occasion well. Gunners are willing to undergo great physical stress in the call of duty. Guns are moved at all costs to ensure that fire is delivered. Longewala is one glowing example where, because their gun towers, which provide mobility, had broken down, the guns were manhandled by the gunners all through the night to reach their gun position. It is because of this prime importance attached to guns that an instructor in gunnery is given the distinction of wearing a red band while teaching in the School of Artillery. The regimental traditions are followed proudly in the officers' messes, where the grandeur and pageantry of the regiment is in full evidence. The tradition of honor and glory is enshrined in the Artillery War Memorial at the Artillery Center, Nasik, where the regiment pays homage to its heroes. Helping the regiment in its pursuit of excellence are its training institutions. The artillery centers at Nasik and Hyderabad take on the task of molding raw recruits who come from different parts of India into responsible, brave young gunners. New recruits pass through systematic grooming, both mentally and physically, and emerge as confident, smart young men capable of taking on any adversary through the power of the gunner. The oath-taking ceremony finally transforms the recruit into a gunner who will henceforth swear by his gun. The School of Artillery at Deolali is responsible for training officers and men of the field and surveillance and target acquisition branches. The Air Defense and Guided Missile School at Gopalpur trains officers and men of the Air Defense branch. Training at these institutions concentrates on detailed knowledge of weapon systems and the art of gunnery. This is based on sophisticated training aids, and high technology is being introduced through computer-based systems, so that the Indian gunners keep abreast of the demands of the modern battlefield. During the last World War, Winston Churchill said, "Renown awaits the commander who first in this war restores artillery to its prime importance on the battlefield." The Indian Regiment of Artillery is implementing this dictum. The artillery is conscious that its soldiers and officers... The artillery is conscious that its officers and men and their families are its most valuable resource. Welfare centers are organized to provide vocational training to families. War widows' children are looked after in a special hostel. Men of different religions are given the best facilities to practice their faith. In fact, these religious institutions and...
जो कुछ मिलता है इस परिश्रम के फलस्वरूप कटाई करने के बाद गेहूं के वो सुनहरे दाने अनाज
The artillery is conscious that the its officers and men and their families are its most valuable resource. Welfare centers are organized to provide vocational training to families. War widows' children are looked after in a special hostel. Men of different religions are given the best facilities to practice their faith. In fact, these religious institutions are symbols of national integration, as different religious ceremonies are attended by all. Special shopping facilities are provided, and well-managed clubs and institutions enable gunner families to relax and strengthen the bonds of brotherhood. A brotherhood which has been many repeat. A brotherhood which has been manifested also in the field of team sports and adventure, where the gunners have excelled. They have achieved distinctions in mountaineering, riding and polo, hang gliding and car rallies. Their sportsmen have achieved laurels in wrestling and weightlifting. Facilities are freely available for participating in all types of sports and adventure activities. The artillery is conscious that its officers and men and their families are its most valuable resource. Welfare centers are organized to provide vocational training to families. War widows' children are looked after in a special hostel. Men of different religions are given the best facilities to practice their faith. In fact, these religious institutions are symbols of national integration, as different religious ceremonies are attended by all. Special shopping facilities are provided, and well-managed clubs and institutions enable gunner families to relax and strengthen the bonds of brotherhood. A brotherhood which has been manifested also in the field of team sports and adventure, where the gunners have excelled. They have achieved distinctions in mountaineering, riding and polo, hang gliding and in car rallies. Their sportsmen have achieved laurels in wrestling and weightlifting. Facilities are freely available for participating in all types of sports and adventure activities. This adding the finishing touch to the process of making the life and career of the Indian gunner a truly multifaceted and satisfying one as he plays his key role in the nation's defense effort. And so, with the new century only a decade away and infinite possibilities in front of it, for the regiment of artillery, even the sky is no limit.
बच्चे उठे तो चारों तरफ फूल खिल गए, जब मुस्कुरा दिए तो कई जख्म सिल गए। भारत की ये युवा पीढ़ी, कल के ये नागरिक, जिनके कंधों पर हमारे देश का भार होगा, उसे समृद्धि सुख की मंजिल की तरफ ले जाने।
We are the dead. To you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high. If ye break with us who die, We shall not sleep.
सामने जवाहरलाल नेहरू का वो चित्र।
We are the dead.
जिनकी जन्मशती
देश मना रहा है। Failing hands,
बच्चे चाचा नेहरू को
बहुत प्यारे। Be yours to hold it high.
3,800 से
अधिक बच्चे इस परेड में
भाग ले रहे हैं।
We shall not sleep.
इनकी चुस्ती, इनकी हवाएं, इनके बढ़ते कदम, ये परिचायक हैं, इनके निश्चय हैं, इनके
फेलिंग हैंड्स वी थ्रो द टॉर्च बी योर्स टू होल्ड इट हाई इफ वी ब्रेक फेथ विद अस टू डाई
देश का ध्वज, देश की एकता, देश की अखंडता इन नौनिहालों के हाथों में सुरक्षित हैं। इस बात का कमान देते हुए और ये देखिए पीछे जो बच्चे हैं पंक्तिबद्ध, जहाँ इस प्रकार अनुशासित बहुत ही ढंग के साथ एक साथ क्रियाएं करते थे। हर देशवासी को इन बालकों पर नाज है। और इस प्रकार गणतंत्र दिवस 1989 पर आयोजित ये भव्य परेड आपने देखी, इसमें झलक दिखाई दी हमारे देश के शौर्य परंपराओं की, हमारी सैन्य शक्ति की, हमारे विकास और प्रगति की, हमारी सांस्कृतिक परंपराओं की और हमारी युवा पीढ़ी की। राष्ट्रपति श्री आर वेंकटरामन, उनके बाएं ओर उपराष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर शंकर दयाल शर्मा, फिर श्रीमती सोनिया गांधी और उनके बाद विराजमान हैं रक्षा मंत्री श्री कृष्णचंद्र पंत। देश का ये ध्वज, हमारी राष्ट्रीय पताका और राजपथ के दोनों ओर अनगिनत भारतवासी, आभास होता है जैसे सारा भारत आज के शुभ अवसर पर यहाँ राजपथ पर विजय चौक और इंडिया गेट के बीच और उससे आगे भी लाल किले तक से मटाया हुआ। ये हैं राष्ट्रपति अंगरक्षक।
जंगली माहौल अब हमारे आकाश पर भी छा गया है।
और आकाश की ऊंचाइयों में इंद्रधनुषी रंग के ये रंग बिरंगे गुब्बारे और यहाँ धरती पर राजपथ पर अब राष्ट्रपति जी पधार रहे हैं और उनके मायोर हैं हमारे देश में आए हुए मान्य अतिथि वियतनाम की कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी की केंद्रीय समिति के महासचिव। अनगिनत गुब्बारे साथ में राष्ट्रीय पताकाएं राष्ट्रपति जी के साथ आप पधार रहे हैं वियतनाम की कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी के केंद्रीय समिति के महासचिव महामहिम वन वन लिन जो कि इन दिनों हमारे देश में पधारे हुए हैं। नीला आकाश और उसकी पृष्ठभूमि में ये रंगीन गुब्बारे उनके साथ झूलते हुए ध्वज आसमान की ऊंचाइयों की तरफ बढ़ते हुए हमारी आकांक्षाओं के प्रतीक कहा जा सकता है। जिस प्रकार देश सुख समृद्धि की तरफ उन ऊंचाइयों की तरफ बढ़ रहा है कुछ उसका ही एक रूप ये गुब्बारे। राष्ट्रपति जी महामहिम वन वन लिन के साथ अब राष्ट्रपति भवन की ओर प्रस्थान कर रहे हैं। आगे आगे उनका अंग रक्षक घुड़सवार सैनिक और एक बार फिर भी आकर्षक मन भावन दृश्य आसमान जैसे कटोरा और उसमें अनेक रंग छाए हुए हैं। और अब उपराष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर शंकर दयाल शर्मा और श्रीमती शर्मा पाठा रहे प्रधानमंत्री जी से विदा की। प्रधानमंत्री श्री राजीव गांधी और अब रक्षा मंत्री से प्रधानमंत्री श्री राजीव गांधी और श्रीमती सोनिया गांधी वापस प्रस्थान कर रहे हैं। और इस प्रकार ये भव्य परेड आज के इस राष्ट्रीय पर्व पर संपन्न होती है इस मंगल कामना के साथ कि हमारा देश खुशियों की मंजिल की तरफ प्रगति की मंजिल की तरफ विकास की मंजिल की तरफ निरंतर इसी प्रकार बढ़ता रहे और हम अपने राष्ट्रीय ध्वज के नेतृत्व में आगे की तरफ कदम बढ़ाते रहें।